Okay, I'm going to load up capital G while y'all think about it. Guatemala. This one has a fun time signature. And a lot of tracks. My goodness. Bam. Look at all those tracks. Guatemala. Yeah, why does he say Guatemala? Why doesn't he say Guatemala? That always confused me. I was like, is there another place called Guatemala that I don't know about? I'm just not learned. Guatemala? Makes me think of guacamole. Just delicious. Wow, there's so many layers here. This is crazy pants. But it is a really great song. This one was on the radio, right? This is like a single, capital G. He's mocking Bush. Yeah. Okay, let's read the lyrics first. All right. Capital G. I pushed a button and elected him to office and he pushed a button and it dropped a bomb. You pushed the button and could watch it on the television. Those motherfuckers didn't last too long. Ha, ha. I always thought of them more as a ha, ha. Not a ha, ha, but a ha, ha. Okay. I'm sick of hearing about the haves and the have-nots. Have some personal accountability. The biggest problem with the way that we've been doing things is the more we let you have, the more that I'll be keeping for me. While I used to stand for something, now I'm on my hands and knees. Traded in my God for this one, and he signs his name with a capital G. Don't give a shit about the temperature in Guatemala. Don't really see what all the fuss is about. Ain't gonna worry about no future generations, and I'm sure somebody gonna figure it out. Don't try to tell me how some power can corrupt a person. You haven't had enough to know what it's like. You're only angry because you wish you were in my position. Now nod your head because you know that I'm right. All right. Oh, well, I used to stand for something, but forgot what that could be. There's a lot of me inside you. Maybe you're afraid to see. And then the last. So it sounds like this is from the perspective of a politician, right? This is not from our perspective. G for George. Yeah. I always thought it was God. But yeah, you're right. It could be so many other things. George, God, gun, greed. Nice. Here we go.
I pushed the button and elected him to office and he pushed the button and dropped the bomb. You pushed the button and can watch it on the television. Those motherfuckers didn't last too long. I'm sick of hearing about the haves and the have-nots. Have some personal accountability. The biggest problem with the way that we've been doing things is the more we let you have, the less that I'll be keeping for me. Well, I used to stand for something. Now I'm on my hands and knees. Training in my God for this one. He sends his name with the capital G. Generations and I'm just somebody gonna figure it out. Don't try to tell me how some power can corrupt a person. You haven't had enough to know what it's like. You're only angry cause you wish you were in my position. Now nod your head because you know that I'm right. Thank you.
accidentally end right there? Weird. Damn. Okay, so first of all, I think this might be the only song that Trent Reznor has written in this time signature. So it already has such a unique sound. I think it's like 12-8 or something. Yeah, that's what I would guess. So that's just, yeah. It's got such a fun swinging sound. And with these drums, right? With these like kind of heavy distorted drums, fat snare. It's really, it's like satisfying and unusual sounding. So just the drum groove alone is, I love the way a lot of these phrases end with, and then there's this rest at the end of the phrase. That's so exciting every time it happens, and everything cuts out there. So I love those moments. He's good at doing that. He did that with like Wish, this sort of like, also felt that a little bit with the song we just listened to a few ago. Survivalism. Like, he's good about using his negative space in percussive ways. And that second snare hit is so exciting. It's so syncopated and fun. I love it. So this is a cool groove. Let's look at some of the other layers. Bass. Oh! Phrygian. Yeah, it's so different. D. Okay, so. Let me just create a piano track. 1 moment. Down, 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 down. There we go. Okay, so. Yeah, just kind of circling around D. And then this part, this is the, so then the chorus has like actual sort of progression of D, then flat six, yes. Then three, flat three, then four. So the flat six is the best in the whole world. I have probably already established this, right? Flat six just creates some amazing harmonies. It sounds so dramatic. And then flat three is very like kind of dejected sounding, kind of near the bottom, but not quite all the way at the bottom. And then the four is a very solid chord to hit right before you go back to the beginning. It's a really like stable, well, I mean, shouldn't say stable. It's a very strong choice right before you go back to one. Like, so many bands use that note in the bass. It's so good. So it's kind of a good setup right there. And then let's see. Oh, clap. Extra clap in the chorus. Did you hear that dissonance? Okay. So he's hitting this major third. That's a very hymn thing to do. Sorry. F. D, sorry. Then he stays on that note when we go on the flat six, and you get this super weird sound. That's weird. No pop artist would allow that. They would not stand for it. It's so strange. You want him to go up. You want him to go... like that. But he doesn't. And I bet you he did it on purpose. And then he goes up. And when he goes up to the note you want him to go up to, he's already onto a different note in the bass, and that creates tension. So he's just subverting your expectations and your desire for resolution every step. Until you get there.
No future generations, and I'm sure somebody gonna figure it out. Don't try to tell me how some power can corrupt a person to know what it's like. You're wrong. And I'm right, all right. Well, I used to stand for something. There's a lot of me inside you. Maybe you're afraid to...
Okay, let's look at his vocal melody. So, well, I used to stand for something. Forgot how that could be. Am I saying the right words? I don't know. There's a lot of me inside you. Maybe you're afraid to see... A lot of repetition once again, so it's a really nice hook. Just keeps repeating. Will I you? Oh, flat six. Four is so satisfying. So bluesy. Yeah, so the melody works really well over the other bass line notes just because they have a relationship with the previous bass line notes. So D is related to the F that we hear in a moment because they are part of the same chord. So... they both sound really nice. Anyway, it's a great melody. Da 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 da. Tons of syncopation. If you write music, just keep that in mind. Like, there are lots of things that make melodies good, but one of them is rhythm, and it doesn't get talked about a whole lot. You know, talk more about like the pitches and everything, but and repetition and patterns and things. But syncopation makes things catchy. Because it's a more human rhythm than just straight notes, straight beats. It's just really great. So.
Hands and knees, traded him back out for this one. And he signs his name with the capital J.
Wait, I want to hear that. Where is that? What the fuck? Those are horns.
I bet on J.
No way. I don't know. Saxophones, maybe? You think he's just saying hey, hey, hey over and over
again? Capital G.
More screaming people. He's so good at finding those screams and looping them. Whoa.
And he signs his name with the capital G.
Military. Does that sound like military drums? What? Are you kidding me? What is going on? What just happened? Why does it feel like suddenly in like a marching band? Doot. This is great. Circle six, greed. Okay, yes, maybe greed. Trent on sax. That's right. He plays saxophone. Oh my god. This is nuts. Okay.
Capital G.
Hook there, so. Okay. This is a great hook. So it's like he took his vocal melody and then just made it a little more interesting and made it into a guitar solo, right? So instead of da 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 da, it goes da. So it's just like a variation of that, I guess, and it has a lot of swing on it. If I were a jazz musician, I would go nuts right now. I'd just start like playing a bunch of jazz chords with that because it does kind of. It just has like this jazzy sound. And it's just like minor pentatonic notes or like blues scale notes. And then underneath it. But this part da 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 is just a variation of a fucker, what that could be, right? So he's just reinterpreting his melody in guitar form, and but nice low gritty tone. It's so such a trendy thing to do. Also, most musicians probably instinctively, if they were like just playing like a drone or something on their guitar, they probably would pick this note because it's the tonal center. So that would just make a lot of sense to kind of balance out those bassline notes with a harmony that's the tonal center. Instead, he goes one note below it to a tenth spot to this. So then you have. It's just so funky. Oh! Oh, and there's a tritone. Then we have So then we have Okay, so now we have so tensonant is kind of what my brain tried to say. Tensonant. What the fuck is that? I don't know. It's great. So trendy. There's another horn thing. It says horn, so I have to figure out what it is. I can't believe this. I had no idea there were all these horns in this song. That sounds like a sampler. It doesn't sound like him playing that. He didn't bring his sax on the tour bus. Okay, another horn's coming back. Hang on. More horns and snares. Okay, that's pretty dope. Listen to the drummer. That's some kind of hemiola or something. That's some sort of cool polyrhythm. Wait, what is he doing? What is it? I can't even do it. This is crazy. I had no idea. Okay. Okay, other layers that we haven't discovered yet. Okay, drums. Lots of guitars, lots of crowds. What's this percussion layer? Let's see what this is. Okay, right, that's the tambourine. Oh, hang on. Yeah, the tambourine's also accenting what the snare is hitting. That's great. What an interesting song. Yeah, of course, before we go, I have to talk about just the way he sings this, right? This is just such an interesting vocal style.
You push the button and can watch it on the television. Those motherfuckers didn't last.
Once again, glottal stops, if that's what it's called. Television. He doesn't even say television because he doesn't have to. He can just go television.
It's too long. I'm sick of hearing about the haves and the have not.
I wonder how he came up with this whole like style. Like what inspired this? For me, I'm not in this song.
I have some personal accountability. The biggest problem with the way that we've been doing things is the more we let you have, the less that I'll be keeping for me. Well, I used to stand for something. Now I'm on my hands and knees, trading in my God for this one. And he signs his name with the capital G.
Super mocking, just like...
Don't give a shit about the
shit. Not even shit. Shit.
Temperature in Guatemala.
He's also got some vocal fry. Look at me acting like I'm a vocal coach. I don't know. I just pick things up every so often.
Don't really see what all the fuss is about. Ain't gonna worry about no future generations.
What a cool accent. Yeah, it's totally syncopated. So exciting.
Just somebody gonna figure it out.
I should say, just in case any of you don't know what syncopated means, it means like off beats. So like if this is the beat, it's not that. that would be syncopated. Okay.
Don't try to tell me how some power can corrupt a person. You haven't had enough to know what it's like. You're only angry cause you wish you were in my position. Now nod your head because you know that I'm right. Alright! Well, I used to stand for something.
Where are the background vocals? We gotta find those. Cause that we got at least that's what I thought. I thought there were background vocals at one point.
Yeah. Before God, what that could be. There's a lot of me inside you. Maybe you're afraid to see. Well, I used to stand for something. Before God, what that could be.
Yeah, they are. Okay, here we go.
Afraid to see. Well, I used to stand for something. Now I'm on my hands and knees. Traded in my God for this one. And he signs his name with the capital J.
I love these. Pretty, pretty falsetto. Flat six. Ugh. I like how it kind of starts like it doesn't start right away on the downbeat. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just very pretty. Pentatonic, minor pentatonic scale to the rescue. Okay, now let's clear this part.
Well, I used to stand for something. What that could be. Of me and Sancho. Afraid to say.
Harmonies.
To stand for something.
Cool.
My hands and knees.
Okay, that was beautiful.
My hands and knees. My hands and knees.
It would take me too long to break all that apart, but some really cool dissonances, but nothing that's like, it's not like tritone dissonance. So it sounds really pleasing, but also like a lot of notes next to each other.
My hands and knees.
It's exciting.
McCall for this one. His name with the capital J.
Oh, and hey now. Capital J. I always thought it resolved to the major third there. It doesn't. My dreams have been crushed. Restner. No, it's okay. Capital J. I thought it was capital J. Those are beautiful.
Peace. My God for this one.
I mean, I always heard that, like, my God for this one, but I don't think I realized how complex all those harmonies were. That's beautiful. There's more. Fucking A. Look at that. Background vocal 2, background vocal 3. Oh, shit. Okay.
To stand for something. To stand, yeah, for, to stand something. For something. My head. Something, yeah, to stand for something.
It's already almost 9:50. Okay, we have to wrap this up.
To stand for some.
So he's harmonizing with himself in octaves there. To stand for
something. To stand, yeah, for something. For something. My hands to stand for something. Look, yeah, out for this one for something. His name with the capital J.
Just going down the scale. So beautiful. All right.